In this video, we're going to talk about how to convert a molecule drawn as a line diagram into a Fischer projection. Okay, so we're going to do it step by step and map out all the different steps, and hopefully by the end of this you'll be able to figure out how to take any line diagram and convert it into a Fischer projection. And the way we're going to do it is actually a little bit unconventional. The most conventional way to do it is to do a lot of bond rotations, and actually we're not going to do a lot of bond rotations here. So what I've done is drawn out a very simple molecule here. This is an example of a molecule which we could convert into a Fischer projection. And we'll actually talk about the Fischer projection in a second. We're just going to concentrate on this molecule first. So here we've got our molecule. We should maybe first number all the carbons. That would really help so that we know exactly what we're going to talk about here. Number the carbons. And the next step, and this is going to be very important, is to identify the stereocenters and then determine whether they're R or S. So the Fischer is really only usually worth doing if you've got a molecule which has a stereocenter on it. And in fact, most of the molecules we really care about Fischer projections for, like sugars and amino acids, of course, are molecules which have chiral centers. And this is another example right here. So what we're going to do is we're going to figure out R and S for each of the stereocenters. And hopefully you can identify the fact that we've got two stereocenters here. So carbon 2 and carbon 3 are stereocenters. So for carbon 2, what is this, the designation of carbon 2 here? Carbon 2, let's look at the four different groups we've got attached. Carbon 2, well, hydrogen would be 4, right? And then we've got the oxygen would be 1. We've got two carbons attached. Now these two carbons, we'd have a tie here, but if we look a little further, carbon 1 is attached to H, H, and H, and carbon 3 is attached to chlorine carbon, this carbon down here, and H. So therefore, carbon 3 will be the second priority, and carbon 1 will be the third priority. So when we trace a line, if you saw a previous video on how we do this trick, we trace a line between 1, 2, and 3, and in this case, it's clockwise. Now, the trick here is that actually this would be R if number 4 was pointing in the back, so if number 4 was a dash. But here, number 4 is a wedge, so we're actually going to reverse this, and this is actually S. So carbon 2 is S, and we can actually go through, figure out R and S for the other stereocenter. What would that look like? So we've got chlorine, which is going to be number 1. Actually, slightly different color here. All right, so chlorine is going to be number 1. The hydrogen is going to be number 4. And then we've got our two carbons. This carbon is attached to H, H, and H. This carbon is attached to O, C, and H. So carbon 2 is going to be higher priority. So therefore, this will be priority 2, this will be priority 3. And in this case, we go 1, 2, and 3, and it is clockwise, which would make it R, and number 4 is in the back. So number 4 is in the back, carbon 3 is R. Okay, good. And so, done. We figured out R and S for our line diagram. And that's really a precursor to doing the Fischer projection, because it's going to, how we draw our Fischer is going to depend on everything. And so drawing our Fischer out, it would be important to, first of all, I'm going to write this as draw a bad Fischer. And really what I don't mean draw a bad Fischer in that you're not going to really accurately represent the molecule. You want to just get the carbon skeleton down. Maybe bad, instead of bad, I'd say rough. Draw a rough Fischer. Okay, so what we're going to do, remember how the Fischer projection works. The Fischer projection, we have our skeleton, which is one horizontal line, and vertical line, and then the horizontal lines, Fischer's drawn flat but remember that the horizontal lines are actually pointing out of the page. As I say, the arms come out to hug you and or strangle you, and the top lines go back into the page, okay? So, but we don't actually draw the dashes and wedges, we just draw it flat. But you're supposed to just remember that the Fischer projection represents that. Okay, so what we're gonna have to do is to map out our Fischer, our line wedge diagram onto our Fischer projection. So let's do that. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. So we should have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. Okay, and we're gonna make this top one carbon 1. So it should be CH3. And carbon 2 is next. Now, like I said, when I say draw a rough Fischer, I'm gonna say just, it doesn't, initially for our purposes, it doesn't matter where you put the OH and the H. Just put them in somewhere. We're gonna correct this later, but we're just gonna put them in first. And then the next thing is you look at carbon 3, and again, doesn't really matter, we'll just arbitrarily put chlorine on the right and hydrogen on the left. Again, this could be not quite correct. We may have screwed this up. It might not actually be accurate. It might not be 2s, and this might not be 3r, but I think the point is just to get, just draw your Fischer first, and then worry about the stereochemistry. That's the point. Okay, so we've drawn our rough Fischer. Now, what we're gonna do is see if we've drawn it correctly. So, figure out R and S on Fischer and correct if necessary. So let's figure out for carbon number 2 whether this is R or S. So let's have a look here. We've got carbon 2 is attached to OH, we said is 1, the H is 4, this is, we said, is priority 2, this is priority 3. So we would be going this direction 1, 2, 3, which is clockwise, which is R. However, remember on the Fischer, like I said, on the horizontal lines, they come out of the page. So H is actually in the front. So what we need to do is, if you saw the previous video on that simple trick to how to figure out R and S when your number 4 is pointing out of the page, we're just gonna reverse. So actually this should be S. So as drawn, this should be S. And actually it turns out that carbon 2 is S. So that's actually correct. So carbon 2 is drawn correctly, which is great. Okay, and then carbon 3, let's draw that out. So carbon 3, we gotta erase our old markings here, and then we'll go around to doing this. Okay. So carbon 3, we said chlorine is number 1. We said this carbon is number 2. The CH3 is carbon 3, and the H is actually carbon 4. So if we go in this direction, 1, 2, and 3, they go counterclockwise, which would be S, but again, our H is pointing out of the page. So we actually, again, reverse, and it's actually R. So just by blind luck, we've actually drawn this correctly, but I didn't plan that. It's drawn, we guessed correctly that this is 2S3R, but let's say that instead I'd drawn my Fischer projection differently. So let's just change this. So imagine that instead of guessing that the chlorine was on the right-hand side, maybe the chlorine was on the left-hand side instead. So if I'd drawn as my rough Fischer, drawn this, then what I would do is figure out my R and S. So this would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So this would be, according to this, this would be, it looks like R, but then it's, we reverse it, it's actually S. So then I would have to have, if I'd drawn this initially, I would have to flip it because it would have been, this is incorrect. Carbon 3 is drawn as the S and it should be R. So we'd flip, we'd then, in that case, we'd flip it. Okay. So H and Cl. So that's what I would recommend, how I would recommend drawing or converting a line diagram into a Fischer projection. Like I said, it's possible to do the bond rotations and then flip it on its back and make sure everything works. And there's nothing wrong with that, especially if you have a model kit. But I think it might be faster for you to simply take your line diagram, identify R and S, draw a rough Fischer where you just put everything, put your stereocenters down any which way, and then you take a guess, you know, with your stereocenters, and then later you can figure out the R and S on your Fischer projection and correct accordingly. So, hope you find this helpful.